Ciao Leonardo Vespace Pianist here. Today I want to share with you the beauty of a great composition by Claude Debussy, which is Estampes. Now I will focus on the first one, Pagodes. Debussy was a game changer and a genius composer that was also the influence for Ravel, Boulez, Satie and so on. And that was absorbing the spirit of the time and got different type of influences that it was filtering through the Western techniques for the music composition. Pagodes is inspired by the structures for temples or palaces that you can see in China, Japan and in other parts of Asia. Is based on many pentatonic way to use the harmony, and it is a jewel. Also, Pagodes was heavily inspired from the view that Debussy got about gamelan, because there was an international expo. And people in that time were starting traveling more, at least the rich one, or who was moving for commerce reasons. And it is a little bit like now, where there are the first space tourists, and where the view of the society is having another big change. Regarding Pagodes, it is structured in a relatively classical form, so it is ABA plus a coda, an outro, to use a more modern term. And it is full of rhythmic games, rhythmic escamotage that makes this composition unique. Now, this wants to be an introduction to this amazing music to who never listened to it before, and that maybe wants to start studying it, playing it, and it is really amazing. With this amazing opening, Debussy is directly giving to the listener a nuance of the Far East, of this exotic lands, still nowadays, even though society changed completely. And it is beautiful to see how he's playing with the color textures, how he's layering up sounds. And inside this ABA macro structure, there are different areas, that is also beautiful to analyze. And there is the continuous reinventing of the fundamental material that he chose to use. There is the pentatonic use that later on Debussy used in an extended way also in many other compositions. And Debussy is referred as an impressionist, symbolist composer. It's true, because his music was somehow new, and it was influenced by the Impressionism, by the artistic movement of time, but more than to the paintings, Debussy was influenced by literature. And a sentence that I found interesting by Debussy, more or less, was that if you can't travel, you can do it with your imagination. And these stamps, starting from pagodes, definitely do it. So, after the first part that starts like this, as we saw. And it has moments like this. The part B with a giant opening and a different way to play the material with the material. Debussy is playing with polyrhythms. It is doing a beautiful Tetris that is definitely crafted by a master. And this episode arrives to the part after, which is this one. And also here it opens to a series of games of working the detail that I find stunning. And here goes back to the part A of the beginning. And so on. And here you have the same sub-elements, sub-groups of the first part that are modified, there are variations. And it is a beautiful build-up that leads to the coda. And we arrive to the coda with an explosion, with a climax. And the coda is characterized by very fast notes, where still you feel the soul, the root that inspired this composition. So here the build-up. Thank you. Here, Debussy at the end wrote La Sévibre. I don't speak French, but it means allow to the vibrations to go on of the strings. And I really find this amazing. Here in this coda there are three levels with the bass, the melody, and this third layer, which is magic. And also here there is this Tetris with polyrhythms that makes this short composition a literary jewel. So I hope that I inspired you, I got you interested, listen to, there are very good interpretations, very good pianist playing Debussy. This was Pagoz. Next time, always from Stamps, there will be La Suarenda Granada, the evening in Granada, Spain, so we change country. So, if you liked this video, hit the like button and consider to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and see you next time.